Welcome. This video discusses optimizing the payment flow for mobile payments within the Facebook local currency payment system. In certain regions of the world, most notably developing countries, mobile payments are becoming increasingly prominent. Either direct to a user's phone bill or via SMS, payment with the user's mobile carrier may often prove to be the most popular payment method in a given region. It is therefore valuable to optimize the payment flow for users who are likely to want to pay with their mobile. Typically, mobile payments are only available at fixed price points for a given user. If you do not price your items specifically at these mobile price points, and the user chooses to pay through mobile, Facebook will handle altering the price automatically on your behalf. This results in the user being charged an additional fee to cover the difference between the original price for your item and the price Facebook was forced to charge due to carrier restrictions. This is known as price jumping, and is fully explained in part 3 of this video series. To avoid this poor user experience of the user being charged a fee, you can build your store from the ground up to support payment through mobile. This requires two steps. The first is to establish upfront the mobile price points available for a given user, so that you can price your items accordingly. The second is to detect when the user wishes to pay through mobile, and shortcut them to the mobile payment flow, bypassing all other payment methods. This is known as mobile shortcutting. Typically, the price points available to a user through mobile payments will differ from the ideal pricing you would choose within your app. The recommended workaround for this issue is to build two pricing tables and user flows within your store, one for credit card and PayPal, etc., as described in part 3 of this video series, and one dedicated to mobile. Here, in the Facebook sample game Friend Smash, you can see the button Pay with Mobile. This brings up a secondary pricing table, which lists products for sale that are purposefully priced at available mobile price points for this user. These price points and options will differ from user to user, as their mobile carriers and therefore pricing constraints change, so you need to be flexible with what you have on offer. But the benefit is that you guarantee an optimal purchase flow, with no price jumping or additional fees. To assist you in being able to price flexibly, we recommend that you implement a virtual currency into your app. Doing this will allow you to alter the quantity of the currency you offer at a given time, to respond to these changing pricing constraints. Of course, to be able to price items like this requires you know upfront what mobile price points are available for a given user. Facebook enables this through the Graph API. With a user access token, you can query for the payment_mobile_price_points field on the user object. You'll get back a JSON encoded string which contains information about the user's available mobile price points. The exact data returned will vary depending on what Facebook knows about this particular user's mobile, but if they've registered their phone number with Facebook, we will return the following fields. User_currency. This is the three-letter internationally standardized code for this user's preferred currency. Mobile_country. This is the country in which their mobile phone is registered. Phone_number_last_4. This is the last four digits of their registered phone number. Then there's an array called price points, which contains the actual price point information available to this user. Each one carries with it ID, which you need for mobile shortcutting. This will be explained in a moment. Payer_amount. This is the actual price point the user will pay. Payout_base_amount. This is the amount the developer gets before Facebook's 30% revenue share, but after the mobile carrier's fee. Currency. This is the currency of this price point. And country. This is the country that this price point is available in. It's also, of course, possible that the user hasn't registered a mobile phone with Facebook. In these circumstances, we won't return mobile_country or phone_number_last_4 because we don't know them. Instead, we will attempt to return predicted_mobile_country. This is not guaranteed, but Facebook will do its best to return the country in which it best believes the user is likely to have a mobile phone. In the price points array, we will return price points of the predicted country and other potential countries for this user. In this situation, we recommend you provide a drop-down so that the user can select in which country their mobile is registered. Once you have this information, you can now build out a dedicated mobile pricing table, and make it responsive to each user's differing requirements. The next step is to enable mobile shortcutting, to bypass all other payment methods and take the user straight to a mobile checkout flow. To do this, we alter the code which calls the fb.ui method to spawn the pay dialog. Please watch part 3 of this video series for a full description of how the pay dialog works. If we look at the code from the friend smash sample, you can see we have a dedicated method for handling a user clicking on a buy button within the mobile version of the store. Because we already know the user is choosing to pay via their mobile, we can safely shortcut them to a mobile checkout flow. By the way, all this code for FriendSmash and this payment solution is fully open source and available for you to download. Check out the FB Samples GitHub page for more information. In the first parameter that we pass to fb.ui, we add in one additional key value pair. The key is pricePoint_ID, and the value is the ID of the pricePoint which we had returned to us previously from our Graph API call. This pricePoint will override any pricing information found inside the OG product object for this item, and will instead price the item at the associated price for this pricePoint ID. If we run this code, you'll see we bypass all options to pay via a credit card or PayPal, and are instead taken straight to the mobile checkout. Finally, note that it is possible for a user to revert back to paying via a non-mobile method. We will, in this case, revert back to accepting the price defined in your OG product object, so it's important that you ensure these objects are priced consistently and appropriately. For more information, please see the URL listed here. Thanks.